Hey, what's up, y'all? It's, you know, I've been doing some periodic videos for a couple years now, and I don't really do them that often, and I really wanted to get into the habit of doing a more routine video structure this year, and I have some plans for some other, like, I guess, like, shows that you would call it, but what I really wanted to start doing was, like, a daily vlog where I could talk about just some news stories that happen to catch my eye during the day. If you've ever watched any of my other videos, you know that I typically have a tech focus. But these videos may not all be about tech. It's just whatever happened to catch my eye in the news that day. There are a lot of tech stuff that happens that I really wanted to call attention to. And over the last year, I've really gotten heavy into Linux. I've been a Linux user for a number of years now, but I've gone full bore. My main rig at home is 100% Linux. And so there's probably going to be a lot of talk about that. And to kick it off, for this vlog, so I didn't want to just start off with like, hey, here's this new video series I'm going to do, but you have to wait till tomorrow to find out when I'm going to post more stuff. Today, I wanted to start off with something that's nice and easy. So what I wanted to talk about today was the new Sling TV service from Dish. And it really caught my eye because I've been a cord cutter for a couple years now too. I typically run XBMC in my living room, and I have a home NAS that has all my stuff stored to it and then whatever I can find on the internet. But over the last couple years, I found that I just don't watch things that come typically on cable. I may watch some new shows or stuff that's on Netflix, but most of the time, I'm watching podcasts and I'm watching stuff on YouTube, and it's really exploded for me over the last couple of years because I haven't had cable. I've been able to reach out to these other content creators that exist on the web, and at this point, trying to dabble in it a little bit myself to find out if maybe I can create content on the web that maybe there's someone out there interested. Even if they're not interested, it just gives me an outlet to talk about this kind of stuff. And I don't want to get into details about the Sling TV. There's a ton of news stories out there. The one that I caught was on Engadget. And I listened to it, a couple guys talk about it on Cord Killers, but what I wanted to talk about was just what I think about the service. And yeah, you get a decent amount of channels. The big thing is that you get ESPN. One of the things I was happy to get rid of out of my life was watching professional sports, including things like ESPN. I like, as some people have said, it's like the TMZ of sports. So, and I've been a lot happier because I've had a lot of extra free time, so I don't watch sports anymore. I'm actually able to go out and do other stuff that I actually want to do. But I guess this is a big deal because you can get ESPN and you can get a couple other channels. There's some weird quirks with it. What's really exciting to me is that this is just another way that people can be delivered this media. And with it being over the web, that means that there's going to be more people encouraged to try out other content. So the people who have been on the fence of cutting the cord, they'll finally do it because there's this $20 service from Dish that can give them some live channels. And then if they live in an area where they can get an antenna, which I've done a video here on how to build your own antenna. If you live in an area so you combine an antenna with the Sling TV, then you have a pretty good setup for a live TV. And then you supplement it with Netflix or Hulu or Amazon, whatever you want to supplement it in there. But that's where it gets kind of great for me, is that it's really cool that there's this new service and you can get it for cheap. It'll get people off of regular TV. They'll start to look at other content. Maybe they'll find some more content on the web. But when you really start looking at it, when it comes to cost, things don't really break down that well. And you can add in the service, you can add on $5 and you can add on blocks. They haven't announced what those blocks are yet. But like I said, if you buy an antenna and you get this service and you're subscribed to Netflix, and maybe Netflix doesn't have everything that you want to watch, so you're subscribed to Hulu at the same time, that's $10 a month for Amazon. That's roughly $10 a month for Hulu. That's 20 plus 20 for the Sling TV, so that's 40. You know, we're looking at $40-$45 for taxes and everything for TV. Just seems like you're not really saving any money, and that's what everyone wants to do when they cut the cord, is that it's to save money. And I really think it's the wrong area, in that cable companies are really trying to shift their stuff around to make some people happy, but still keep their old model. So this doesn't really look like it's a win for consumers in the long run, because this price is going to go up. I mean, I guess if there's a lot of people that watch it, the price could go down. But to be realistic, the price is probably going to go up, and Netflix and Hulu prices are going to continue to go up here and there as well. So if you're wanting to save money, your best bet is just an antenna and the internet, and go find some new content creators. If you have any comments on this format or what to talk about, or if you have something that you want my opinion on, go ahead and leave the comments below. Subscribe, tell me what you think. You can check me out on Twitter @DomCorvo or on Facebook @DominicCorvo. And